Who are you to wave your finger? You must have been out your hair. I hold deep in muddy water.
Doug, good morning. Yep, that's right. It's me, Uncle Lou, live for you on YouTube today. Thanks for watching. Yeah, good morning. Uncle Lou here. Thanks for watching. Two previews in one today. I'm trying to fit in as many previews as I can. Run out of time. So we got two previews coming up today. Real quick before we start into the previews. Today is Monday. You know what that means? Tell me how you feel. Normally we do this at 2 o'clock every Monday. It's a live call-in show broadcasted live here on YouTube, on my channel here. With a phone number, you call in, ask me questions, argue with me, ever what you want to do. Normally we do that every Monday, 2 o'clock Eastern. Well, the eclipse has messed me up, but I have reached an agreement with the eclipse. The eclipse has agreed to end by around 4 or so today. So we're going to do today's show a little bit later. We're going to do it at 6 p.m. Eastern time. So the call-in show will still be today, Monday, but it's going to be at 6 p.m. Now, this will give some of you who may be haven't been able to call in the past an opportunity to call in because it's a little bit later. So tell me how you feel. Live call-in show today, Monday, 6 p.m. Eastern. Now, Vanderbilt in Kentucky. That's today's preview. Okay, a spoiler there for you. And
Bush Pirate title too, and I already knew that, didn't you?
Anyway, here's what the two biggest questions I always get from Vanderbilt and Kentucky fans this offseason. Uncle Lou, do you think we have a chance to compete in the SEC East this year? Do we have a chance? Uncle Lou, do we have a chance? Both fan bases are telling me the same thing. Uncle Lou, we had a good year last year. We're on the up, we're on the rise. We're on the come up, we're getting better. Do we have a chance to win the SEC East? Yeah. I mean, right now, everybody's got a chance to win the SEC East. Everyone's undefeated, and everyone's going 15-0. I mean, that's the way the offseason works. Now, here's the thing, you can look this up if you don't believe me. Chance and likelihood are not synonyms. Chance and probably are not synonyms. Chance and are going to happen, not synonymous.
So you're telling me there's a chance?
Yeah! So, I mean, what you watch the previews, let me know what you think down below. Let me know what teams you want to see next. Like I said, we're running out of time. So whatever teams you really, really want to see, let me know down below. Preview time. Previews. Got to do the two for one. We're running out of time here before the season starts, and Vanderbilt and Kentucky are two good teams to do together at the same time. They have a lot in common and some similar expectations and delusions from both of these two fan bases. I'm going to have to do this a little bit quicker than I normally do. It's no disrespect to these two teams. It's just that I'm running out of time. Next week is going to be hate week videos, I'll be making UGA videos against App State and, you know, probably do something on some of the other big games too. So I have to wrap the previews up this week. So we might have a couple of days this week where I do two teams at once. But anyway, let's start with Vanderbilt.
Vanderbilt!
You guys know how we do it by now. Non-con first, then I'll run through the conference schedule. So week one at Middle Tennessee State. I'm giving you a win here, okay? Let's just start that right off the bat. I'm giving you a win. So cut me some slack later on down the list here if you're not happy with something. This isn't a gimme game for Vandy at all, but I'm going to give you the win here, and it's at Middle Tennessee State. Do not let the SEC down. Do not let Uncle Lou down and lose this game, Vandy.
Vanderbilt!
If you lose this game week one, forget everything you've been trying to tell me in the offseason, okay? Okay? If you cannot win this game, forget everything you've been telling me in the offseason because it was all wrong, okay? So I'm giving you the W. Week two, you come home, Alabama A&M. I'll give you a W there. So you're starting off 2-0, okay? Congratulations. Week three, Kansas State at home. Toss-up. And I almost picked Kansas State in this game. Since it's at home, I'm putting it in the toss-up category. Kansas State is a dangerous team. Offensively, they're pretty good. Defensively, they're not very good. The problem is you're sort of the opposite. You know, you don't have a very good offense. And you have a pretty good defense. So this will be an interesting matchup, their offense against your defense. Can you score 28 points and win this game? I don't know. Toss up right now. This is an interesting matchup, though, SEC versus Big 12. Got it in the toss-up category. And then your final non-conference game later in the year, what is this, your eighth game, I think it is, ninth game. At home, Western Kentucky. I gave you a win there. Again, Vanderbilt, don't sleep on them. This could be one of those games that embarrasses the SEC. Don't let it happen, but I gave you the win. So in your non-con, three wins and a toss-up. So, hey, and now keep that in mind when we go through the rest of this video. That's fair, right? Three wins and a toss-up, I think Vandy would take that. If you told Vanderbilt fan right now you can go 3-1 in your four non-con games, I think they would probably take that. And I've got you possibly 4-0, three wins and a toss-up. All right, now for the bad news. The SEC schedule. Your first SEC game this year is at home. That's great. Bad news against Alabama, it's a loss. I mean, come on. Not even Vanderbilt fans think they're beating Alabama. It's not happening. Just be realistic. Goes from bad to worse for you. The week after that, you have to play Florida at Florida. That's a loss. Florida's not losing at home to you. I don't see it happening. I mean, that's just what it is. The next week, home against UGA, loss. You're not beating UGA. I know you beat us last year at our place.
How in the hell do you lose to Vanderbilt at home? On homecoming!
Look back in history. How many times have you beat UJ 2 years in a row? I'll wait while you look. It may take you a while. You're not winning this game. That was one of the worst games Georgia's played in a long, long time, and we gave it away at the end. But not happening this year. You're toting an L to UGA. I'm sorry. That's just the way it is. All right, then you go on the road to your first West team, Ole Miss. I have that as a toss-up. I think you should beat Ole Miss. But they're hard to figure out. I've said this every time I mention Ole Miss. You don't know what you're getting with them, what sort of motivation that they're going to have. This is midway point of the season. Their wheels could be falling off by this point. Who knows? But I've got it as a toss-up. That takes you into your bye week. Then you go on the road at South Carolina. Loss. I think South Carolina beats you at home in what will most likely be a night game. Then you've got Kentucky at home and Mizzou at home in back-to-back weeks. I've got both of those as toss-ups. And in my opinion, you're probably going to go 1-1 there. But I've got them both in the toss-up category for purposes of this video. And you finish up the season like you always do at Tennessee. I have that as a toss-up because you drubbed them last year. 1,000 yards and 70 points almost, whatever it was. So I've got that as a toss-up. Tennessee fan is 100% sure they're beating you. It's at Tennessee. Tennessee will be favored in this game. Again, I'm giving you guys the benefit of the doubt here. I'm putting that as a toss-up. So that puts you at 3 guaranteed wins, 4 guaranteed losses, 5 toss-ups. So things go really bad, you could be looking at 3 or 4 wins. If things go really, really good, 8 wins. I don't see that happening. I think Vanderbilt and Kentucky, when they play, the third to the last week of the season. So around the first couple of weeks of November when y'all play. I think the winner of that Kentucky-Vanderbilt game will probably make a bowl, and the loser probably won't. That's just the way it is. So there you go with the Vanderbilt.
Vanderbilt!
Now, on to Kentucky. I got to speed this up. On to Kentucky, same way. So your non-conference first is at Southern Miss. What's up with you and Vanderbilt scheduling these away games for week one? But anyway, at Southern Miss, I gave you the win. But again... Don't sleep on them. Don't embarrass the SEC here. If you lose this game, apologize to me and forget everything that you said during the offseason because your season is over at that point if that happens, okay? But I'm giving you a W at Southern Miss. Then you come home, take on Eastern Kentucky. Another W for you there. Let's see. your next non-con game at home against Eastern Michigan. I gave you a W there. I'm being generous. Some of these games could be put in the toss-up category. I'm giving you wins here, okay? Do not let me down. And then your final non-conference game, of course, at the end of the year, Louisville. Great game last year. You beat them. A huge upset. Not happening this year. Louisville and Lamar Jackson gets revenge. Beat you at home at their place. And you towed an L there. So in your non-con, that gives you one, two, what, three wins in the non-conference? Yeah, three wins in your non-conference and a loss. So 3-1. So there you go. Now, conference schedule. First conference game, week 3 at South Carolina. I have that as a toss-up game. I think this is a huge game for Kentucky. There's two games, well, three games, really, I think, are almost must-wins for Kentucky, especially if Kentucky's going to do what they say they're going to do, which is win 8, 9, 10 games this year and contend for the East, which, you know, spoiler alert, not happening. Here's a visual aid for you Kentucky fans, because talking to you or typing things to you and trying to use common sense and football terms and things like that just isn't working. So here's a visual aid for you to try to understand the SEC East here. Yeah, I mean, that's just that's there you go. That's the you can put a stupid hat on and, you know, drink some crazy type of drink, need a pimento cheese sandwich or whatever it is y'all do up there at Kentucky Derby, but that's what it is, okay? So at South Carolina, I have that as a toss-up game. And then you get Florida at home. That's a loss. You beat them, what, twice in 40 years or something? That's a loss. Then home against Mizzou, toss-up. You have to win this game. This is the second of the third pivotal game. South Carolina, Mizzou. Those you've got to win. You've got to be winning these games if you want to be a legit team. You've got to be beating these teams. So we'll see. I've got it as a toss up. That takes you to your bye week. All right, then you go on the road to your West team, Mississippi State. That's a loss. I've said it before. I think Mississippi State is going to be better than what people think this year, and I don't think you beat them on the road. Then you come home, play Tennessee. That's a loss. Tennessee's beating you. They always beat you. That's just what it is. You're losing that game. Then at home against Ole Miss, toss up for all the same reasons I've said all offseason about Ole Miss. Don't know what you're getting. This is the ninth game of the season. They could have mailed it in by then. That's the best case scenario for you, that they just don't care at that point. I got this listed as a toss up. That's not a knock on Kentucky. That's just me admitting I don't know what the hell I'm getting from Ole Miss this year. Then you go at Vandy. Already told you that's a toss-up, but that's the third must-win for you. Look, South Carolina, Mizzou, and Vandy. You got to win those games if what you're telling Uncle Lou is true, okay? Then you go on the road. UGA, bad news for you. You're losing that one. This was a great game last year. We hit a last-second field goal to beat you in your place. Hot Rod 4-for-4 that day. You're the real MVP, Hot Rod. Thank you, sir. You deserve a scholarship still. I'm working on it, sir. Believe me. And then you finish up the season, like I mentioned before, with an L to Louisville. So that puts Kentucky at 3 wins, 5 losses, 4 toss-ups. Okay? Now, those three games that I had as toss-ups that are must-wins, you know, if you win all three of those, okay, that puts you at 6 wins. Okay? And then that means you got to beat then Ole Miss if you want to get to 7 wins. I don't know if you're going 4-for-4 in the toss-up category and finishing with 7 wins, but it, you know, it's possible. But I don't, like I said, I think the winner of the Vandy-Kentucky game makes a bowl game and the loser doesn't. Anyway, that's it. Sorry I had to do this one shorter than the others. No disrespect intended to either one of these teams. I'm just running out of time and trying to make sure I get in as many teams as I can. Have a great day.
Hey.
Right there to subscribe. Right there to watch Preston previews. Beep, bloop.